Right, so this is a new lesson in our iterating series, and we will discuss how we can make another 3D logo from scratch using an PNG. So let's get
Hello
started.
Everyone, welcome. My name is Kamil Tami, and I will be your instructor in this class. So 3D logos by itself is an art, and today I will discuss how you can recreate the Zoom logo. I have checked my desktop, and I have chosen three old logos. And I will show you how you can recreate it from scratch, and we will discuss also how we can enhance the original logo by a new one. So let's get started. I will move to the top view with 7 in the numpad. Because I am professional, I will not use any reference. I will start from a plane. This may be scaled to be 1, and I will check in the edit mode. I will check all these vertex, and I will hit Control Shift B for the level, and let us bevel this one. So I will add some curves such as this, and if you have the chance, you can go such as this, and you can increase it if you'd like. If you have time, you can reconnect all of these so you don't have any angles, by join. The next step is to add some thickness. So let's go here and extrude by selecting all and extrude around 0.2. The next step is to add a new object, which is the camera. So this is the base. You can hit F2 and click on this one to be the base, of course. And after that, I will add a plane. Let's scale it 0.5, then I will scale it 0.4, maybe such as this. And after that, I will scale in X, select both and Control Shift B, such as this. Then we can go here and move this plane. I'll move 0.21. Let's extrude 0.1, and after that, let's move it here and increase the depth. Then I will put the cursor here and add a plane. Let's scale it 0.1 and scale in Y this edge. Feel free to add any bevel for this one and extrude. Select all and add some bevel 0.01. That's fine. And this one also, you can add bevel for it, 0.01, and this may be 9. You are good here. And what about the base? Of course, you can't add a subdivision surface if you didn't join. So let's join all these. So this is the original, but you can add an shade smooth such as this, or you can join. So I have joined all the vertex, as you can see, and now it's smooth after adding a subdivision surface, maybe 3. So now it's smooth. So we have 2 options here. This is the original. You have 2 options. You can make the camera be extruded to the up, and or you can add the boolean. So let's add the boolean, of course, here,
And let's check this one. Maybe add another boolean and check this one. So let's hide. Here we are. For this one, we can add smooth. Let's try the edge split. All right, so the edge split will work, and we can move this in the X 0.02. And this will be our final. So we can add smooth to it. And smooth to it, and it will be such as this. And this is the original. Let's see how we can improve it. Select all and move to original collection. What happens here? And let's move in the Y. So I will select this one and duplicate in the Y, and after that let's move to enhanced collection, and I will go to Shift C selection to cursor, and let's add an abelian scale 0.1, scale X 0.1 or 0.2. Move in the Y, scale Y such as this. Then we can Shift D or Z. What happens here? We must add this and R is Z45 and Shift D or Z45, and let's duplicate this few times. Then we have all these parts, which is an abelian. Sorry for my language. And we can add here, this is the light, and we will add a camera. Let's add an abelian, another abelian. As usual, we start from an abelian, and I will add loop cut here, another loop cut here. Control B. We need only 1.9 and another loop cut here. Let's edit this face and let's add small one here. And we separate it at this is the lens, and after that we can select this one and extrude in X, scale in Y. And the scale in Y 0.7. Here we are. This is the camera. We can extrude, of course, and add some bevel. You are welcome. So I will move this one here, and let's scale. Scale Shift Z 0.8. Okay, and let's remove all this in the right, and this light will be the backlight of the camera. This is our concept, and we can move it in the X axis such as this, and all of these elements will be moved and extruded. So let's add a bevel. We add here a bevel segment 5.01. And select all of these and Control L, copy modifiers.
So this is a new one and this is old. I will move it in the enhanced. And now we are in the material section. Of course, you need a blend. So I will hit Shift A and add blend and scale it 6 times. After that, I'm using an add-on which is for free. You can go to Blender Market. I will leave the link in the description and choose metal or let's choose metal and this one may be good. All these 25 materials are for free and if you like you can purchase of course the full 20 materials. It's realistic. And for this one it's in blue, so let's go for the shader editor. This is one which is the blue plastic and we will choose specular 0.7, roughness 0.2 and base color. For the zoom we can go to YouTube and check the color and I think it's this blue. For this one which will be an white. For